faster than he drives in the car, I can vouch for that.
Peter Jacobson there, Alan, in car 76 of the Cortina, a very well-prepared motor car and goes very well also. New paint job and the old regular 55 on the side.
Well, Joe Sherwell got a bit of free publicity during the week with the ad for this particular meeting. It's the one in the street stocks, Neil Hoffman, over the, I'm not sure whether it's Wakery, but one of the Riverland clubs. Now, it was wrong. Now, those are ringing. Dave Burgess in 77, and those who are sharing that car this season, and they'll be taking alternate drives, and I think the story was Peter is driving in the final. So, because I'd like to see that one come across first every time now. Now, here's Hoppy. There are definitely two cars down there with that, that Premier Licky, I think, in the other car. That's the one I mentioned with the number wrong in the program in 95, yes. I don't know about the drivers, but I'm going to have a bit of trouble in that corner. But let's have a look. 74, it's Stephen Murphy, the car that got out in front, and Meisner going down the fast straight right up underneath. He's going to pass on the inside going into that corner. Car 48, Rick Gibbs in third place, and they've spread out fairly well. But Meisner got a good start around that first corner. Glenn Wallace and Warren Meisner, it is still out in first place, followed by Stephen Murphy. Car number 48 is Rick Gibbs. Hobbs. Car number 20, a little further back, Glenn Wallace. He started on pole and dropped back. Sam Horton moving up. Tracy Hobson, second to last, and car 25, Trevor Best is the last car of all. We won't worry about the last one because they're a little bit too far back, although I think we might see some action with those motor cars there. It's still Warren Meisner out in front of the go-kart. Rodney Hobson, and then we've got a long gap in front of the boys are going to come out of those first cars. And Warren Meisner from the Riverland area, as I said, one of the organisers of this particular event, certainly doing fairly well. We may have a pass up on the Deakin Avenue corner. And the second car goes out wide. And Gibbs comes through on the inside. Got level, he'll get through on the pit. It is that car of Gibbs who is now up in second place behind Warren Meisner, who comes out of the Deakin Avenue corner. Can't be too much to go in this race. Meisner looks great.
Now,
that shows the way clear there at the moment as they go into that sun and we lose track of them. But we can see that they've all negotiated the pit corner without a great deal of hazard. It's that car 65 of David O'Rourke, the AV Trophy car, that's showing the way there as they come into the pit corner for the very first time. Again, I lose them as they go down under the end of the sun. But car 128 has gone a little bit wide there, and that allows the Piranha to slip in underneath.
That's Hoffman now.
Hoffman. Right, now Hoffman is in third place there as he's on his way up. Third form. I've lost time. I'm back there a bit. The girl ladder is there on the personal place. But it's the leaders we're looking at here at the moment, and these boys are going very, very well out in front. You are certainly right, Alan. David O'Rourke has set up a blistering pace here. And he, just as I talk about him, he rolls it, spins her out in front, and he has stolen the thread. So that's put him out. Now that's... There is Sullivan. Is it Sullivan? Counter what out in front now. Yeah, the 295. That's right. Sullivan is that's showing the way there from Hoffman. 79 in third place as the field is well and truly clear. What are you saying? Back to the rear of the field. Here he comes there now. He's let it go. But these other cars we've got over the outside there at the moment, that of Grill in third place, the car 79. Car of Sullivan it is that's showing the way here now. Climbing all over his back bumper, trying to find his way. Great night, down the straight, it's over there now. Sitting in a great place there at the moment, of course, with not forgetting Darryl Payne, the Wakery car there in fourth. This is very close racing. It's Hoffman comes on the inside, and he holds O'Sullivan out long enough to get through. No, O'Sullivan has managed down in the pit corner to pick the race in control. He goes fairly wide, and this allows Hoffman now to come underneath him. Up the crunch down the main straightaway. And no, he backed off a little bit. There must be a little bit of leaning. Oh, goodness me, we've got a set of brakes there, forcing that car 128. Darryl Payne to go on the inside. Darryl will not be too keen with that, and I don't think the Chief Steward will also be keen on him doing what he did. Down the back straight today, Sullivan managed to hold the Hoffman out. So can he hang on long enough to do it? With Grilson is there in third placing. Around they go now, and these places don't look like they're going to change. Hoppy can't get through, and thumbs up to you, Hoppy, he said.